This video introduces decision-making and uncertainty through linear programming. In other videos, we discussed decision-making under uncertainty, where we do not know for sure the results each alternative action will produce. This type of decision problem can be frequently solved using statistical techniques with good judgment and experience. Some of the examples include buying stocks and building apartment complexes, when we do not know the market demand. The decision tree is a frequently used tool to solve this type of problem, which is demonstrated in the decision analysis module. In contrast, if we do know the outcome of each alternative action, we are facing a decision-making problem under certainty. For example, when a company here can produce two different types of auto products, A and B, this company tries to decide how many A and B to produce. This is a decision-making problem with certainty, as the company has all the information regarding producing A and B. This information includes how many hours it takes to produce each A and B, and the total number of machine hours available at the company. For this type of problem, decision-making under certainty, we will use linear programming to solve them. Linear programming, in fact, has nothing to do with computer programming despite its name. This type of technique was first adopted for military uses where training schedule, logistics supply, and deployment of combat units were all referred to as programs. Linear programming tries to find the optimal solutions, so it's also known as linear optimization. Optimization allows managers to make better decisions involving either maximizing or minimizing some objective functions subject to certain constraints. Linear in linear programming refers to that both the objective functions and constraints are linear. This is, in fact, the easiest type of programming compared to other programming techniques, for example, dynamic programming. To motivate you further, I'd recommend watching this short clip to see how UPS uses linear programming to optimize delivery routes. It's a pretty fun video. The link is provided on the call site. Linear programming has a lot of real-life business applications. These applications can be classified under different types of applications. For example, the UPS routing problem is considered a traveling salesman problem. Linear programming is very useful for efficient manufacturing and production. For example, there are oil fields in Saudi Arabia, oil refineries in Japan and Australia, and customers in the US and New Zealand. What raw oil should be shipped to which refineries? Another type of application is in scheduling. For example, pilot and crew scheduling. Linear programming is quite useful in finance, especially portfolio optimization. For example, how to minimize portfolio risk while achieving a certain return? I have also classified these applications according to different business areas, including marketing, finance, and operation management. For more examples, please refer to LINGO's website. This is the introductory example that you have seen a few slides ago. I will explain how to carry out a decision-making analysis with certainty using this example. Please pause the video here and read it again. There are pretty much four steps in dealing with linear programming problems. Other than the first step, that is to formulate the problem, the remaining three steps are all associated with solving the problem. Regardless of the business application, we would always have to choose a linear programming program to solve this business problem. LINGO is a powerful tool designed to build and solve linear, nonlinear, and many other types of optimization models. For this class, students are not expected to purchase a license key. The free trial version will be completely sufficient and can be downloaded from the LINGO system's website. If for any reason that Lingo does not work for your own computer, feel free to access Lingo using remote access to our computer lab or go into the lab in person if possible. If you're using a PC, be sure to click on Demo when you run the program for the very first time. For Mac users, please do the same after installing Lingo on your computer. Instead of using Lingo, we could also use Excel Solver to build and solve linear programming problems. Excel Solver is a built-in tool in Excel. You can check whether Solver has already been loaded in your Excel. Click on the Data tab, and then Solver on the right. If Solver does not show up, you may need to load and enable it in Excel first. Instructions can be found using this link here. Now, let's go through each of the four steps using the introductory example. In step one, we formulate the decision problem using a mathematical or linear programming model. The real-life business scenario is described on the left side with many pieces of information, including different features of A and B and machine hours. At the end of the step one, we would like to present all the useful information using a mathematical model that the software is able to comprehend. And that's the model presented on the right side. This mathematical model is built using Lingo. In step one, we first would need to define the decision variables. These variables are the unknown quantities that are estimated using the linear programming solver. In this problem, the company tries to estimate how many A and B they should manufacture every week. So there should be two decision variables. One is for the number of A to be produced, and the other is for the number of B to be produced. We need to represent these variables using mathematical symbols, and I will use A and B here, respectively. I'd highly recommend using meaningful and the relevant names for these variables, not X, Y, Z, that you will quickly forget what they represent. For this problem, the decision variables are somewhat easy to be identified. In general, defining decision variables is usually the most challenging part of the problem formulation. The decision variables are usually placed at the very top of your model. When you define the decision variables, you probably want to provide a little bit more explanations for these variables to prevent future confusion. This explanation or comments are very important when working with other people on the same problem. These comments will be completely ignored by Lingo. To comment out certain lines in Lingo, we place an explanation mark at the beginning of each line. Another Lingo syntax is to end every line with a semicolon. This is probably one of the most frequent sources of error when writing programs in Lingo. Another Lingo syntax is that the variable names are case sensitive. So capitalized A and small letter A are treated as two variables by Lingo. Let's move on to the next part, where we state the objective function. What's the purpose of finding the best production plan for this particular company? It is about maximizing total weekly profit. So we want to state this objective function in Lingo or Excel Solver. First, we want to express the total profit first before we can maximize it. At this moment, we don't know how many A and B should be produced by this company. That's the whole point of this decision problem. Just assume that we produced 5 units of A and 10 units of B. The total profit is going to be 3 multiplied by 5 plus 4 multiplied by 10. That's $55. If we produce A units of A and B units of B, the total profit should be 3A plus 4B. The objective function is to maximize the total profit. So now we can state the objective function as max equals to 3 times A plus 4 times B. Make sure you capitalize max and end this line with a semicolon. Just a remark here. In Lingo, the objective function is either a max or a minimum, min. And you should feel free to use all the mathematical operations, including additions, multiplications, left and right brackets, strictly less than or equal to signs. The last part of a problem formulation is to state the constraints. The constraints are usually more than one. For this particular problem, the constraints are related to machine hours. In order to maximize profit, the company definitely wants to produce as many units of A and units of B as possible. But this production plan is not feasible because this company only has two grinders that work 40 hours each and three finishers. We have to make sure the production plan will not exceed the maximum machine hours. How do we express that using mathematical equations? First, let's express the total grinding hours and make sure this number does not exceed the total capacity of two grinders. A takes 2 hours of grinding, and B takes 2 hours of grinding as well. So the total grinding hours is going to be 2 times A plus 2 times B. For two grinders that work 40 hours each, that will be 80 hours in total. Therefore, 2A plus 2B should be less than or equal to 80. Using the same kind of a strategy, we can make sure the total hours of finishing do not exceed the capacity provided by the three finishers as well. A takes 2 hours of finishing and B takes 4 hours of finishing. So 2A plus 4B is less than or equal to 120. Please pause this video here and see if you understand these two constraints. We now have translated the original business problem into a mathematical model. The model includes two decision variables and one objective function and two constraints. This model is ready to be entered into a linear programming solver to find the optimal values of A and B that maximize the objective function. We are now done with step 1. In step 2, we just enter the mathematical model into a solver. In Lingo, the window that we enter this model is called the Lingo model. To run the program, we will click on the target icon at the very top, which is also known as a solver icon. The screenshot here is from a PC. Mac screenshots are provided at the end of this video. In step 3, we obtain computer printouts. We will not discuss the sensitivity analysis for the scope of this class. After clicking on the target icon, two additional windows should appear. One of them is called the solver status, which summarizes the optimization problem and presents the status of optimization. For example, for our problem, the class of this model is LP, which stands for linear programming. There are two variables and three constraints. This is because objective function is also counted as a constraint by Lingo. Our example is very simple to optimize. It took 0 seconds for Lingo to complete and only 2 iterations. The optimal value of the objective function is 140. Another window is called a solution report. If this one does not show up, please click on Window tab on the very top and choose Solution Report. This window includes the optimal solution and the objective function value along with other useful information for our decision-making process. First of all, the optimal solutions for A and B are 20 and 20 respectively. When the decision variables take the optimal solutions, that are 20 for A and 20 for B, the value of optimal objective function is 140, as shown here. Therefore, the maximum weekly profit for this company is $140 when it produces 20 units of A and 20 units of B. Here is the screenshot from Mac version of Lingo. The interface looks slightly different, but it contains all the essential icons. So this is the target icon, which is also known as a solver. The optimal solutions and strategies are identical. This company should produce 20 units of A and 20 units of B to obtain the highest weekly profit of $140. This also concludes the introduction to linear programming, the decision-making under certainty. In subsequent videos, I will go through several examples to show you how we can formulate and solve the problem. I hope you find this introduction video comprehensive and easy to follow. This concludes our video.